Good day, YouTube. So today I am updating my Galaxy J5, which was launched back in 2015, from stock Marshmallow to unofficial Android Pie 9.0. My model of J5 is J500G, which is on stock 6.0.1. ROM is already tested by me and testing went very well, except two things not working, which are NFC and VoLTE. So do not flash the ROM if you are using VoLTE and NFC in your daily drive routine. Two things that I would like to mention here. First, always read my video description about what are the things working and not working, and downloading the required files for the procedure. And second thing is, many users complained that they having problem with their Galaxy J5 after flashing custom ROM, like not booting or having a boot loop or data not working or something more like that. Well, in this case, I would say that concentration always required watching tutorial videos, and search always first about your device if your model is different, then proceed. I have only J500G for testing custom ROM on it and never face any problems. As per the developer team who ported this ROM for Galaxy J5 2015 family, that ROM working fine with all the variant of J5, but two things not working that is mentioned already by me are the NFC and VoLTE. We all know that custom ROMs may never be 100% stable, but also, we are not getting the modifications in stock ROM that we get in custom ROMs. Starting the procedure by telling you to make a backup of your data which are on internal storage, because internal storage will get formatted, so better to save the data on PC hard drive. Get a micro SD card for getting a better experience, because you know that J5 having a less amount of internal storage. Make sure device battery should be charged around 80 to 90%. Go to settings, then to accounts, and sync your Google and Samsung account once, and then remove both account must to avoid any interruption during flushing. Procedure require a data cable for flushing and a computer. I assume you have saved your data and removed both accounts, then power off the device now. Moving towards my computer screen to show about the files which are to be downloaded. Make a new folder to save all the required files there. Download Samsung Android USB driver. Download Odin 3.13.3. Download TWR, means Team Win Recovery, for the particular device model by typing in search bar. Download the Android Pie unofficial ROM for Galaxy J5 family. And last is to download GAPS. Select the platform ARM. Do not go for any other platform because it will not work. Then select Android version 9.0, and variant must be selected PICO, Pico. Then click the red circle to start downloading. First of all, install Samsung Android USB driver on Windows if you do not have it. In case you already have, then no need to reinstall. Unzip Odin 3.13.3, open that unzip folder and open Odin by double clicking it. click AP, then locate the downloaded folder and select the TWRP 3.3.1 and click open. Okay, Odin is ready for flashing the custom recovery. Moving towards my mobile phone now. Device must be power off. We need to boot the device into Odin mode, and for that, hold the device in hands, then press and hold the volume down key, then home key, and then power key. In half second, you're gonna see a warning screen, then release all the keys immediately. And press the volume up key once for to continue. This is the Odin or download screen for flashing via Odin. Connect the cable with device and check the other side of cable must be connected with computer. Windows will start installing drivers if the device connect with computer for the first time. And when Windows prompt that drivers are installed, you're gonna see the Odin will also show a sign that device is properly connected with computer and ready for flashing. Now go to options and uncheck auto reboot, then go back and click on start for to start flashing custom recovery on Galaxy J5. In a few seconds, recovery will get flash and Odin will show pass, which means recovery flash successfully. Disconnect the cable from device which still be in Odin mode. Then remove the back cover and also remove the battery. Then hold for 3 seconds. Now reinsert the battery back in device. Power on the device which will boot into stock Marshmallow ROM. Now reconnect the cable again with J5 to copy 2 files on micro SD card, the custom ROM file and the gaps file to micro SD, which is inserted into Galaxy J5. After copying the files, power off the device. This time, we will boot the device into custom recovery. For that, hold the device in hands, then press and hold the volume up key, then home key and power key. Release all the keys when you see recovery message on top left corner on the device screen. Soon the device will boot into custom recovery. Always make a backup of your current ROM, just in case. If something goes wrong during flashing, then you may restore the backup. Simply tap on backup and do not change anything in selection. In case if your internal storage having little space, then tap on select storage, then select micro SD card, so the backup file will be saved on micro SD card. Swipe to start making a backup. You may save this backup folder later on the computer hard drive for future restoring. In case if you wanna go back to stock ROM, by tapping on the restore and swiping to start restoring, Team Win Recovery will do the job for you, making and restoring backup easily. After finishing backup, now go to main screen. Then tap on Wipe, then Advanced Wipe, and select Delvik Art Cache, Data, Internal Storage, Cache, and System. These partitions only need to be select. Then swipe to start wiping. When done, then go back to main screen. Then tap on Install. Tap on Select Storage. Then select the micro SD card storage because ROM and GAPS files are copied there. Tap OK and here are the files. Select the custom ROM file first and swipe to start flushing Android Pie unofficial custom ROM on the device. Flushing will take around 2 minutes. Wait. And when done, then go back and select the GAPS file this time. And same, swipe to start flushing. This flushing will also take few minutes, so wait for it. Tap on Reboot System when flushing of both files done. Now device will reboot and will start booting the unofficial Android Pie 9.0 custom ROM which is supported for Galaxy J5, and first boot will take a little long time. So wait and let the device to boot the custom ROM. You're gonna see the setup screen on the J5 soon, and do not touch anything on device on this screen. Better to wait on this screen for about 3 minutes and then complete the setup screen. Finally, we have Android Pie 9.0 custom ROM on our Samsung Galaxy J5 2015. I have already tested the ROM and test went really well according to the specification of Galaxy J5 2015 model. Explore the ROM and check the things inside. This ROM is having bunch of modifications which you can see in the settings where you can get or customize the ROM the way you want to use it. I hope your mission must be accomplished to flashing this custom ROM on J5, same just like mine one. Happy flashing and enjoy the Android Pie on Galaxy J5. We'll see you in my next video. Till then, goodbye.